They tend to come from one world that is a certain mind view. Now, a lot of them are very smart, and they work very, very hard. And I think that they, to a degree, the better ones have some self-awareness of that, and they try to work around that. To me, one of the great factors affecting press coverage in this race that is underappreciated is the fundraising angle. Because this is the first presidential campaign that we've had where both candidates were outside of the federal funding for the general election. That's because of President Obama. And let's, you know, make sure that's on the historical record. And one of my frustrations with the reporters when I talk to, a lot of them don't seem to understand this, and they confuse Citizens United decision and the president's decision to get out of the federal funding system.
Which he did in 2008.
Which he did in 2008 before Citizens United. So it had nothing to do with it. And that meant that the Republican candidate, whoever it was, turned out to be Mitt Romney, was going to have to spend a tremendous amount of time after the primary fundraising. That means you spend less time with voters. And I can't tell you how frustrating it is to see a candidate working and an organization working 18, 19 hours a day to raise this terrible amount of money you have to raise to compete with the sitting incumbent president of the United States, who has every advantage in fundraising possible, and have reporters write that, well, you're not really campaigning, and then you get back on the plane, and then you start writing checks of the money you've raised. 70% or so of that money goes to the parent organizations of those news organizations. It goes to, or to the affiliates. So it goes to the ABC affiliate, the NBC affiliate. It goes to CNN. It goes to Yahoo. It goes to Bloomberg. So we are cashing in on
the revenue side from the money that you had to raise, and then you feel unfairly criticizing or not adequately recognizing that you had to spend a lot of time raising money. At the same time, you still could have done more interviews.
And you could also spend more time talking to voters. So what you had this time was, in September and into October, candidates seriously raising funds, particularly our candidate Mitt Romney. And one of the underappreciated successes of the Romney campaign, which I had very little to do with in the fundraising, he had to raise over $100 million a month after he won the primary. And that's an extraordinary task. No one has ever come close to doing that. And he was able to do it. At the same time, people didn't understand that the amount of money that we could spend on television was limited to that which was raised in primary dollars. So it had to be under the 2,500 limit. So we had this situation that was very confusing to reporters and the public at large, which I understand, of we were raising a lot of money, but we couldn't spend that money under these complicated laws that we have now. We couldn't spend it on television. So I think that when you go back and you look at why there was a debate about federal funding in 76, and I've gone back and looked at this recently, I had in my head that it was all anti-corruption after Watergate. That's not true. There was actually a realization that once a president was in office, their ability to raise money was so vast that it was something that should be curtailed for the public good. Forgetting corruption, even if they played by all the rules, whatever those rules were. And it is a shame now that the Obama campaign, President Obama, candidate Obama in 08, let that genie out of the bottle. And the pressure on all of these candidates in the next cycle to raise money and spend more time, which means that you don't spend time with voters. And yes, we raise more money on the internet than any other Republican campaign has ever raised before. And that will increase. But still, you're doing a lot of events. And you're talking to fewer and fewer people when you do those events. And it means that you don't go and door to door. You don't go to forums as much. You just don't meet voters. And I think that's a shame. And I think that also increases pressure on reporters to generate news. Because when you have candidates who are going to fundraisers, and saying pretty much the same thing for the most part, not always, as we saw in the 47%.
Occasionally going off script.
Yes. It's a lot of pressure on them.
Stuart Stevens, thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you.